What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. What's good? So today I'm just recapping on something we had. Is that my water? Oh, I'm out. I'm recapping on something that we had talked about a while ago with Alabama. I believe they passed the bill of you can't have an abortion for 20 weeks. Like, it was just a crazy number like that. Can't remember. When I say drew a blank, but you remember what I'm talking about. And so what I ran across in the news, and I had been meant to talk about it, but just, you know, life happens. An Alabama rep, Rolanda Hollis, she introduced the bill, and this was back in February, like February 17th, 14, 15, 16, 17th. She introduced the bill to send a message to men that they should not be regulating a woman's body. She put a bill in for mandatory vasectomies at the expense of the men, okay? It is meant to neutralize last year's abortion ban. It's in a message that men should not regulate what women do with their bodies because it takes two to tango. Men should be responsible too. What she introduced the bill, it would require a man to undergo a vasectomy at his own expense within 1 month of turning 50 or the birth of his third biological child, or whichever comes first. Of course, backlash for days. You know, a lot of the men, you know, they felt some kind of way. And it's always funny how when it comes down to men and their penises and their testicles, their balls, the snipping and the cutting of their particular body parts, oh, it's a travesty. Oh, don't touch that. You know, that law, almost sure it won't pass. She stated she knew it won't pass, but she just wanted to be the one to put that in their face. While you trying to tell women what to do with their bodies, we need to tell you what to do with your bodies, and that it is not all the woman's responsibility. I can't emphasize enough, your sexual health is not my responsibility. My sexual health is my responsibility. I have to look out for my vagina, for my mouth, okay? For my eyes, because some people like the money shot, you know? Not saying I do, okay? We won't deny or approve that truth. But your body, I'm responsible for it, okay? You're responsible for your penis, your mouth, every part of you. I'm not responsible for that. Even if we both agree, mutually, consensually, to have sex. If you choose not to wear a condom, and I choose not to pursue the issue, then whatever we get coming up out of it is what we get. Because that was the choice we made. I think women have to stop being shamed and made to look like a slut or a whore because she carries condoms. That's another thing. Some women just don't want to be embarrassed. They're going to look like I'm crazy if I just pull out a condom. You're going to look crazy when you get HIV. You're going to look crazy when you have herpes. You're going to look crazy when you have gonorrhea. So your sexual health is your responsibility. Now, I'm not talking about a woman or a man who the choice wasn't given to them because they were lied to or they were raped or something. I am not referring to anyone who did not have a choice. They are not in this conversation. Those scenarios, not in this conversation. The scenarios are consenting adults that want to have sex and don't want to protect themselves or want the woman to be responsible. Or if she let me hit raw, I mean, you know what I'm saying? That's her baby. No, that's your baby too. Okay, I need us as women to be comfortable and not afraid to say, no, you need to wear this condom. Matter of fact, you need to really keep up with your own. Because as much as we do know and have seen women be shady and poke holes in them, you have bitter men who want to get girls pregnant on purpose leave them or to give them VD. Some men who may have been sexually hurt as far as catching a disease or anything, they want to spread they want to spread it. Vice versa, women do it. Carry your own protection. Here's my brand new condoms. This is for us. Okay, I'm protecting us. Also, stop saying stuff like, well, what you got a condom for? You nasty, you don't know if you clean. I know I'm clean. As of today, right here, March the 18th, I am clean. However, if we have sex unprotected today, what if something was lying dormant? There are some diseases, VDs, that lie dormant and may not show. But soon as we have sex, they show in you. Your sexual health is your responsibility. There's no way to get around it. There's nobody to point the finger to. I think that abortion ban in those states where they're taking it up to 20 weeks, it's very cruel and it's unfair to the woman. I also don't believe in abortion as birth control either. However, I believe in you doing you. Okay? I believe in you doing you. I can't do you. You do you. If you use abortion as birth control, if you've had an abortion every which way you can think of getting one, what more power to you, your uterus, and everything else. I don't get down with abortion as birth control. So that's not for me. But if that's for you and you got money like that, drop it like it's hot and drop it right on into the flusher, because that's where it's going. I do feel you have a right to make that choice. If you want an abortion, go get one. You don't want one, don't get one. I don't feel you should be pressured into one. I don't feel you should be coerced into one. I feel it should be something you want to do. But again, your sexual health, you are in charge of that. He is in charge of that. We are in charge of our sexual health, making our own individual decision. So again, we know that that mandatory vasectomy bill will not get passed, but I love that she put it out there to say, hey, you want to keep us in check? Let's keep you in check. So tell me, what do you think? What are your thoughts if that turned out to be a real law? Drop in the comments. Do you think it's fair? Do you think it's fair that they have that abortion ban? You know, let me know what your thoughts are. Again, it's not going to pass. Highly unlikely. She didn't make present it with the thought of it passing. It was to get their minds, like, you're trying to regulate women. Tell me in the comments, what do you think if that happened? Should there be a law? Do you agree that it should be a law regulating men? Do you feel sexual health falls on both parties or just the women? In the comments over here on my page, everyone's opinion is welcome. However, abuse to another person commenting or myself is not allowed. We can have our difference of opinion. We can have strong ones. Like, Kiva, I don't believe in abortion. There are many people that don't believe in abortion at all. They're completely against it. I am completely fine with that. Myself, I don't believe in abortions either. However, I believe in doing what a woman feels she needs to do. I am 46 years old. My tubes have been tied now for 10 years. I do not want any form, peace, or be a part of any child. Don't want it. If I somehow miraculously got pregnant, it would be gone. Without hesitation, I would be at the clinic. People like to say, oh, no, you wouldn't, honey. You don't know what I wouldn't do. I don't want children. It's gotta go. Okay, but again, I don't believe in abortion. I have four children, so hey, they all made it. But I've made a conscientious decision to ensure I don't have any more. So I don't want a mistake, a oopsie, because I know.
Ask Floyd, my dream supporter.
That was my Bluetooth. A company sent me a Bluetooth to review, and clearly it spoke. It said something. Power off. Whatever. But yeah, we're not going to disrespect each other in the comments. I want to have some good commentary. Let me know what you thought about that proposed bill. Again, do you feel sexual health is for us as far as we all are responsible, or is it the woman? Hey, she need to make sure she good and blah, blah, blah. Let's talk about it. And thanks for coming back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hey, click the subscribe button. Take it with your girl. I'm good people. Like, I'm good people. If you're an OG and you've been around from back when I first started taking YouTube seriously and uploading, you're the real MVP. And I love you. Matter of fact, I love all of y'all because y'all take the time to come back over here to my video and kick it with your girl. Y'all leave good, genuine comments. I appreciate that. And I want to say thank you. All right, y'all. I'm out.